Hello dear students, welcome to Ojanga AS Academy. My name is Shibin and I'm your sociology optional faculty. So today let us get into the syllabus analysis. Yesterday I came up with another video on basically the introduction to the optional, how to choose the optional and what are the benefits you get if you select sociology as an optional. And we dealt what is sociology, what is the difference between sociology in UPSC and sociology in academics. So what are the benefits you get when you select sociology as an optional, why you get a lot of marks in sociology, what are the benefits you have when you select sociology as an optional. Sociology does not require much time to prepare. All those things we dealt yesterday in detail. Now we are just analyzing the syllabus. There are actually two parts. This is a part one and I will come up with another part, okay, part two of syllabus analysis. I told you already yesterday, in optional you have two papers for each optional, paper one and paper two. Today we will be dealing about paper one. Paper one deals about the theories of sociology, basically the theories, Western concepts, because the optional actually got evolved in Europe. So we'll deal the Western theories, how the optional, actually the discipline sociology, how it got emerged from Europe. All those things we'll deal in paper one, the theories. In paper two, we'll deal with Indian thinkers, Indian sociology, Indian scholars, then issues like urbanization, agrarian crisis, women, tribes and all, we will deal in paper two. This is paper one, we will deal with Western concepts. What is the, actually how the syllabus, the discipline came to being, how the discipline started and all, we will deal it here, okay? So, these slides actually belong to the paper one, so be careful, okay? Listen to the thinkers and all those things, whichever I am saying. So this is the first slide, sociology syllabus analysis part one. I told you already yesterday, in sociology we deal with everything. See, globalization, inequality, technology, development, research, theory, culture, gender, everything comes under sociology. So in different units, we'll deal different things. Okay, you have 10 units in paper one and 15 units in paper two. So actually in total you have 25 units. So in paper one, you have 10 units. So let us deal one by one, okay? So this is the name of the paper, paper one, fundamentals of sociology. Fundamentals means basic things. The basic theories, basic concepts of the optional. In paper two, they are talking about Indian society. Paper one, you have Western concepts, fundamentals of sociology. So this is the first unit, sociology, the discipline. How in any optional, whenever you study geography, political science or PABAD, you should know what is the development of the syllabus, discipline, how the syllabus came to being. So likewise in paper one also, fund sociology, you have this topic, discipline, the origin of discipline. First one is, from this unit, every year you get questions. Mostly with 20 marks, direct question, what, how the optional, the discipline, what is, how did that originate? And how the changes in Europe in 17th and 18th century, how did it lead to the origin of the discipline? This is a direct question which you get. If you study properly, you get 16 to 17 marks direct question. No doubt, no issues in that. Okay. So the first one is modernity and social changes in Europe and emergence of sociology. You would have studied in history or modern, medieval and modern history. From 16th, 17th century in Europe, there was this concepts called Enlightenment, then Renaissance, then you would have heard about Leonardo da Vinci, Michelangelo, painters like that. Then French Revolution, Industrial Revolution, all these revolutions brought a lot of changes in Europe and it laid the seeds of democracy. Earlier, you know, there were kings, then kingdoms, then king and subjects. When democracy came, it became like the concept of citizenship came. What's the difference between a king and a subject, and what's the difference between the, what is its difference between with the concept of citizenship? In king and kingdom, king rules the subjects, when once when the king dies, his son becomes the next king. They do not ask the permission of people. But in citizenship, in democracy, what happens? Everyone is equal. All are equal. That is what is democracy. By the people, of the people, and for the people. Everyone is equal. And as no, it is not possible that everyone can rule. There has to be some selected people. It is not possible that everyone can become a prime minister or everyone can become a minister. So there are some people who are interested in politics or who are qualified. They will go to politics, they will become minister, they will become prime minister, and they will rule the country. Other people will become doctor, engineer, then teacher and all. So there are differences, but all are equal. That is why it is called the concept of citizenship. So in Europe, from kingdom subject, the concept of democracy came. So how did that changes in society? Actually, it brought a lot of changes. That is, when you study French Revolution and Industrial Revolution, you will come to know how all those in this topic also we will study them in a like a basic way. How these changes led to the development of the concept sociology. Sociology is a relatively very new discipline. It originated in the last just 3-4 centuries back as a discipline. Though the thinking of sociology, how people should behave in society and all, were there in existence. Suppose when you learn the concept of Kautilya or Plato, Aristotle, it was there. But as such, the concepts came in last 3-4 centuries only. Okay, so this is first one. You get a direct question from that. Next is the scope of the subject and comparison with other social sciences. Scope of the subject means basically how it is useful. See, suppose it is not just sociology only. I told in last class also different professors focus on different things. So one professor may focus on tribes, one professor may focus on women and all, one professor may focus on waste management. So in every concept, every area, there is this scope of the subject. One of my professors whom I know, he did about issues in society, and he is a consultant with Delhi police. He is helping them because of his thesis. He has found something in society which actually police people are police officials are making great use of. So this is how again you see now when the corona pandemic is there, people are actually frustrated because people are actually depressed. So in that case, you should have social psychology, social medicine and all, to help the people understand the realities and to counsel them. You should know the topic. It's not just about, as I already told, in sociology we deal with everything. So all topics comes under sociology. So what is the scope of that? Right, even when British people came to India, they did a lot of social thinking, social engineering, how to colonize our country, what kind of education should be given, so that they are able to take some people. That is called the thinking Indian blood, but spirit should be British. That was their thinking. When they select officials for the jobs, they should actually help British people to continue their empire. This was their thinking. So though Indians are working for British people, but they needed these Indian people to work for them, to work for British welfare. So before that, they did a lot of study and they divided people on Muslims and Hindus. It is called divide and rule. They divided people. So for that, they did a lot of study. That is what is called scope of the subject and comparison with other social sciences. So you get a 10 marks question. What is the different relation between sociology and history, sociology and political science, sociology and psychology, sociology and anthropology? These 5-6 subjects are there. It is a very easy topic. Again, you get 10 mark question regularly. It is very easy. Sociology and common sense. It is basically, you see, in common sense, you would say that people will say those who are very tall, those who have very big jaws, such people are very criminal minded, something like that. Or it is like that, even in movies you see that people who are of black color, they are always, mostly they are shown as criminals, and white people are shown as good people. So, but that is just common sense. But in sociology, when you go for research, you know that it is not that always people who are black are not always bad. People who are white are not always good. it depends on their behavior. So this is what is sociology in common sense. In common sense, you have one thinking. Suppose you will think that your friend is always your friend. He will not cheat you. You can trust him. That is your common sense. But what happens in sociology when he get a situation, maybe he will cheat you. So that is the difference between sociology and common sense. Okay. So again, the you see the world map here. It originated in Europe. Then it went to US. It originated in sociology, originated in Europe, Western Europe. Then again, lot of developments took place in US. But now again, because postmodernism and all, many universities are again leading in sociology. Okay. Next unit is sociology as a science and research methods and analysis. These two topics we will learn in a united way, combined way. You get direct 20 marks question from this topic. When you write very good points, you get lot of marks without doubt, because the unit chapter 3, this unit, research methods and analysis, this is actually not sociology. This comes in all social sciences. So when you write these questions from this topic, you get very good marks, because this is not actually sociology. It is a very direct topic. Just study and go and write the exam. Sociology is science. You see, I told already the case when suppose in movies, when you see black people, police officials beating them, showing that they are criminal minded and white people are good. So how do you say that? You cannot say something just by observation, just by saying. You cannot say that. You should actually know the behavior of the person, the black person and white person. You should actually know the behavior. Then only you will understand that how, if the person is good or bad, right? Now you would see you would have seen the case of racism in USA, the case of George Floyd, a black person who was kneed down to death, who was killed, actually murdered, right? So in such cases, this is applicable. Now you see sociology as a science. So there is a debate when your discipline started. Should sociology be like natural sciences, like physics, chemistry, maths, or should it be like philosophy, political science, history, social sciences? So there was a debate. So initially scholars, because during the 18th century, there were people like Newton, Kepler, then Archimedes, scholars, scientists like that. So when science was developing those centuries, what happened those times, what they were making strict laws. Because when you say the Newtonian law, F is equal to ma, or Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. See, this is written equations which is applicable everywhere. But in social sciences, you know, because of people behave in different way in different places. It is not always, suppose you may eat a food in Delhi, you won't eat that food when you go to Kenya. When you go to USA, you will eat some other kind of food, because the climate is different and your food options are different. Again, the cost of food will be different. Maybe you get roti here for 5 rupees, but when you go to Tamil Nadu, you may have to give 10 rupees for roti. In that case, you may eat rice from there, because that is cheaper. So you cannot always put a law and make people behave accordingly always, because people think. But in natural science, it is a stone, or it is just maybe water, so which do not have emotions, which do not think. But human beings think and they act. It is not always that you behave always equally. You behave according to the situation. So that is the difference between sociology as a natural science, or a subject as a natural science, and a subject as a social science. So because of the influence of Newton, Kepler and all, initial scholars in sociology thought we should design sociology like natural sciences. That is the best way. But again, there were discussions and there were scholars who said, no, it is not like natural sciences, it is like social sciences. So these debates, that comes in this topic, very easy topic again. If you study, starts reading again and again, very deep into this, it is very tough then, because it goes beyond the scope of UPSC. They have given only these topics. They will ask only for 20 marks. To study for the syllabus, it is very easy. You get 20 marks easily. Here also, this question is, how do you do research? Suppose you are the present unemployment crisis, and you go to cities, no one is there, everyone has gone to villages. So now when a lot of people are in villages, you should give facilities there. So suppose you are going to you take the case of Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana. You are going to village in Jharkhand, and you are asking people about how, what is their issues, how are they facing, what are their the problems they are facing. So when you go to go for research, what are the plans you should have? You should have a plan in writing. To which kind of people you ask? You will ask male or female, ladies or gentlemen, or then you will ask farmers or carpenters. Will go to Jharkhand or Bihar. So you should have a plan. And what is your generalization? What kind of thinking are you trying to bring out of that? Are you just making for your study, or after your study, are you giving the document to the government so that they can make a policy out of that? Lot of policies of government comes after researchers. So this is how you use research methods and how you use it to benefit the society. See this picture. Okay, so these two units again are very easily scoring. Now this unit, see this brain, this is the main unit in the optional. 60% of the topics comes from this topic, sociological thinkers. In all the questions in your optional, in the previous topics also, you topic unit 2, unit 3, unit 1, and all the upcoming units also, you get points from this. You use these points directly, you get lot of marks from these topics also. Direct questions come. Okay, so study these topics properly. This is why sociology is very easy. You know how, what to study and how to study. See, first one is Karl Marx. You would know, maybe related to left politics, you would have heard this name, Karl Marx. Only four topics are given: historical materialism, mode of production, alienation, class struggle. You have to stick to this. Don't be a Marxian scholar. You don't go much into that, because that is beyond the scope of the optional. Read what is given in the syllabus, what is given as per UPSC. There are a lot of toppers who get a lot of marks, but there are a lot of scholars who have done MA or a PhD in sociology who are not getting much marks, because they know a lot of things and they are not able to write for 20 marks. They are not able to limit, compress their knowledge. So that is why I'm saying you learn what is given the syllabus and fit in your answer sheet. Next is Emily Durkheim, Division of Labor, Social Fact, Suicide, Religion and Society. What is the role of religion? You see this topic, suicide, because of the show Sushant Singh Rajput and the suicides related to Corona, I expect a question on suicide this year. Okay. Next is Max Weber, Social Action, Ideal Types, Authority, Bureaucracy, Protestant Ethic and the Spirit of Capitalism. How people behave and what are the kind of actions done by people. Bureaucracy related to civil service, you can use this in jails for also. Authority, Protestant ethics, it is related to Christianity, how their behaviors, how their ideals influence the spirit of capitalism, development of capitalism in Europe. Next is Talcott Parsons, again a US scholar. So Marx, Durkheim and Weber, they are from Europe. Marx from Germany, Durkheim from France, Weber from Germany, Talcott Parsons, he's from US. Merton, he's also from US. Leighton-Mann Manifest Functions, Conformity and Deviance Reference Group. This concept of reference group is used by M.N. Srinivas in the topic Sanskritization. That is there in paper 2. When we deal that, this is how this is in, these are actually related. Karl Marx, his influences are there in the topic of Air Desai. That is also given in paper 2. So when we learn Karl Marx, you should apply that in Air Desai, paper 2, right? Then Weber, that influence is seen in Bataille, paper 2. Parsons, Merton, this structural functionalism seen in the works of M.N. Srinivas. So a reference group we will use in, we have to study actually. The name is given. I will deal in next analysis. Okay. The next scholar is Mead, Self and Identity. They ask a direct question always from this. So again, this is a very easy unit. How people behave. Suppose you are a boy or girl, a baby, 2 years, 3 years old, how you develop your behavior. That is discussed under Mead, Self and Identity. Next one, stratification ability. Stratification basically means division of people into different categories. Suppose in the civil service itself, you see different stratas, IAS, IFS, IPS, Group A services, Group B services, right? So it is given like that. And in school also, you see headmaster, teachers, then non-teaching staff, students, or prime minister, ministers, the Minister of State, and it comes like that, right? So stratification means, actually the word strata comes from geography. When you learn about that, there are three stratas like crust, mantle and core. From that, this word comes. Mobility means how people are able to move. Mobile means moving. So you would see mobile ambulance. or mobile cot. Sometimes in cities you see there is a like a big lorry truck. It is actually a cot, and if someone is caught riding without a helmet or without documents, he will be put into that cot and he has to give fine and all. So are people able to move it through the society? Suppose your father is a farmer or a shopkeeper, and you get into IAS, then your situation in the society status actually goes up. Now your child will not become a farmer or shopkeeper. He generally would go IAS or above that, because you will give him some inputs. You will influence him. That is mobility, right? So here again you see concepts like equality, inequality, hierarchy, exclusion. So Dalit people are generally excluded from many activities in society. They are not able to participate in temple festivals or marriage processes and all. Poverty and deprivation, this is again a usual question. Theories of social stratification, structural functionalist theory, Marxist theory, Weberian theory. Only you need to study these three theories. They have given it. Okay, so in this comes from this unit social thinkers, sociological thinkers, structural functional persons, Marx, then Weber. That's why I said that unit becomes very important. Once you are very good in that unit, here also get a lot of marks. Then dimensions, class, status, group, gender, ethnicity, and race. Gender, you get always 20 marks question. We'll focus here also, because in sure questions you should get 15, 16 marks. No excuse with that. Ethnicity. Ethnicity is basically, you see Tamil ethnicity or Maharashtra, Maratha ethnicity. You'll see issues like that. Maybe suppose Bihar people are being beaten in Maharashtra because people say this is our soil and you are taking our jobs, like that. Race, see again, this is about biological. In Delhi, you see Northeastern people are abused, called the monkeys and all. They are beaten. Or African people are beaten in Delhi many times because of racist issues. The present issue of George Floyd actually in USA, that is again issue of race. Social mobility, open and closed system. Open and closed means basically about caste and class. We'll deal in the classes in detail. So in closed societies, what happened in caste-based societies, you have a limit to move, because even if you work a lot, you may not become a Brahmin or you may not become into that Varna. So it is very tough. That is why it is called a closed system. Open system basically about class, were not about caste in US and England, European Western societies, where it is about money. If you have a lot of money, you can lead a very rich life, you get a lot of respect. It's not just about caste. In caste, what happened, your birth determines a lot of things, right? But there is a scholar who called M.N. Srinivas. We learned about him in detail in paper 2. He says that there is no system which is absolutely open or absolutely closed. Okay, so we'll deal about that in detail. Types of mobility, sources and causes of mobility. It is a very easy topic. This concept of Sorokin, 20 marks, it is very easy to get. Work and life. So social organization of work in different types of society. Slave society, feudal society, industrial capitalist society. So they may ask you, what are the determinants of work culture in a society? Technology is a factor for work, because when you have C4G, 5G technology, artificial intelligence, when you have very good facility, very very good technological facilities, or if you have very good salary, then if you have very good ambience environment in your work, all these influences your work. Suppose you are a teacher in a school, you need good students. Good students means only not only number of students, but the students who behave properly. You should have good teachers, colleagues with you. You should have good PTA, Parents and Teachers Association, right? And if you have all every day, you have to like travel for 2-3 hours to reach the school, you will find it very difficult. So all these things determine your selection of a school, right? So this is what is called social organization of work, how these factors influence. Next is formal and informal organization of work. We'll deal in detail. So mostly you see this corona issue, pandemic also, many people lost their jobs who are in informal sector. People, yes, there is people in formal sector also lost, but informal sector, even if you lose jobs, it is very difficult for them to find, because they don't have regular salaries and paperwork and all. So they find it very difficult. Okay. So you get a direct question in this topic. Actually, whenever you get a question, we'll learn by writing, as I told already yesterday. We'll deal from six thinkers. This the previous slide, this main thing is from this we will connect this topic. Okay, then it becomes very easy. You have to study very less here, then we'll relate the scholars from here. Okay, next is topic 7. See, this is the great Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, politics and society. I told already, in sociology we deal with everything. This, see this one, politics. Next is religion. This is family. This social change, family, household and marriage, sexual division of labor. Here you see we deal in politics, religion, stratification, work, economic life, then social science, then other subjects. That's what I said. We are dealing with every topic. Okay, politics and society, sociological theories of power. There are some theories of power. Last year also they asked this question. What are the different theories of power? Then power elite, bureaucracy, pressure groups. These are all from current affairs. We learned some scholars also, but you get direct question. Pressure groups. What is the working of pressure groups? Are they actually helping democracy? This is the general question they ask for 20 marks in section B. We should get marks out of this topic. Political parties, nation, state, citizenship, democracy, civil society, ideology. So nation, see, nation. What is the difference between state and a nation? India is a state, but India is not a nation. In India, there are a lot of nations. But suppose you take maybe a country called Serbia, it is a nation state, right? But Croatia, it is a nation state. But in India, we have a lot of nations. So India is a multinational state. And this state is not to be confused with state like Haryana or Punjab. This is the state is basically about a territory having a constitution, which can enforce people to do something. That is basically the concept of state. Okay, our state in preamble also we will see the word. See the difference between nation and state. I will explain again for you to understand. Nation is a group of people who have a similar feeling. They belong to that area. Suppose you see Tamil nationalism or Maratha nationalism, right? But Maharashtra state is also there. When Maharashtra state and nation, that is congruent, that is okay, fixing with each other, it is okay. But Maharashtra becomes a part of the country, great country India, right? So the Maratha nation is different from the concept of India as a state. Okay, civil society group of people, like again pressure groups, presidents association and all those things, ideology, protest, agitation, social movements, collective action and revolution. So how people behave in a society, all those things, movements and all. We have scholars also. These are direct questions. There is no much thing to think about this. Okay. Religion and society. Sociological theories of religion. Here you see sociological theories of power. Here you have religion. Then we have types of religious practices. Animism, monism, pluralism, sects and cults. Suppose you are worshipping a religion which has only one god, right? Monism. If there are a lot of gods, then it is called pluralism. Then sects and cults in religion, there are some different groups which is within the religion, but they have some different practices and they have some people also. So that is called a sect and cult. We'll deal with it in detail. Cult is basically, suppose you take Sai Baba or Sadhguru, they are a cult, right? So people follow cults also. Next is religion in modern society, religion and science. Suppose you see in religion and science, people go for religion and they pray and all to cure a disease. But once they know that, see, it is very dangerous and with religion it is not happening, you have to go to a doctor and take some tablets. Then people go for science. Then even at the end of an operation, surgery, then doctor will come out and say, see, we have done our best. Now you keep praying. Then again, people go back to religion. So how religion and science, are they helping each other? Are they actually creating issues in society? This is the topic, a very interesting topic, again for 20 marks. Secularization, religious revivalism and fundamentalism. Is religion, the influence of religion decreasing in society or it is increasing in society? Are actually you see the conflicts based on religion, fundamentalism, religious revivalism and all. This fundamentalism and revivalism, again a connected topic. Okay, you get a lot of points here. Again, these topics are connected to this topic, sociological thinkers. Next is city systems of kinship, 9th unit. Family, household and marriage. Suppose you're living in a hostel, that is a household, right? Because you don't have connection with people. You are not having blood connection with people. Then family, marriage, types and forms of family. Very easy topics actually, very, very easy topics. lineage and descent, how you term out your generation, your father, grandfather, like that. Patriarchy, basically in every society, men rules the society, and generally it is believed that female people, women don't have much talent. But you see the corona crisis, the health minister of Kerala, KK Shailaja, she got some award from UN. She's dealt with Nipah virus and the present corona crisis, then COVID crisis, then the Prime Minister of New Zealand, Jacinda Ardern, she's also a lady, but now New Zealand has become corona free. They have removed corona from their country. So they are also ladies, but they are also leading the change in society. So it is not always men who are talented. Women are also talented, but sometimes people believe that women are not capable or not able to work in some positions. So that is basically concept of patriarchy and sexual division of labor. That is labor is divided according to sex. Suppose IPS job, you see, people will think that is sexual division, that is suitable only to ladies. Such kind of thinking. Or nurse, it is suitable to women. Or job of a receptionist, that is suitable for a lady. These are the concepts which come under sexual division of labor. Contemporary trends, new trends. Now you see everyone is working. IPS, girls are also working in IPS. UPSC is not charging from girls to apply in exam. Right, in military also girls are coming in large numbers. These are the contemporary trends. And in marriage also, what are the contemporary trends? Love marriages are there. Then gay marriages, lesbian marriages are there. Right, see this picture. Now social change in modern society. Now we studied about society role. Now what is happening change? What are the changes happening in a society? Social change, sociological theories of social change. Here we studied social theories of power, sociological theories of religion. Now we are studying sociological theories of social change. Development dependency, again something related to economics. Very important topic, look at direct question from here. Agents of social change, education and social change, science, technology and social change. So what are reasons for social change? Social movement is again a reason for social change. See this topic, protest, agitation, social movement, right? Religion, fundamentalism is reason for social change. So like that, preamble, constitution. So before we got independence, we were under British rule. Once we got independence, became a democratic society. Anyone can contest election. Now you see Dalit people, ST people are having reservation. So they are also become, now you see our president, he's a Dalit actually. So reservation or the Dalit empowerment also, the post of president is not a reserved post, okay, but I'm just giving how people are improving their life. Education and social change, how education leads. Suppose you completed 10th, then you went to higher secondary, then you went to college, then now you are going to become IAS officers, right? So how education influences you, then you get into IAS, you do a lot of things for the society. Then how you change the society, so that is education and social change. Next is science, technology and social change. Suppose you take the issue of example of Green Revolution. How a lot of, see, we actually change the agricultural landscape of the country. Or you see the concept of nuclear bomb, it actually destroyed the life of a lot of people. Again, it led to social change. It actually destroyed the Japanese society. Now also a lot of people who are born in Japan face this issue, genetic issues because of radiation which happened that time. And science, technology, again you see the now everyone is working from home, the concept of work from home. For that you need high speed internet, right? So society, science, technology and social change. So what happened? If you don't have internet, then you cannot work from home. So once you have internet, you can work from home. That will lead to, maybe if the corona, let us hope it goes very fast, we become free. Suppose it persists for 5-6 months again, then when people work from home, you need to have food from home. Then Swiggy, Zomato, and all, they also, some more companies will come like that, right? So this is what is happening, social change. So you see 10 units, very useful units, when you study properly, 160, 170 guaranteed. Discipline, social science, research methods, sociological thinkers, stratification and work and economic life, politics, religion, family, social change. By heart, the words, so this is what is in paper one. It is a very easy paper. Next I'll come with paper two analysis. By heart the syllabus, wherever, I will help you also when we start the optional. Link through the concepts, it becomes very easy. It is very, which is a very scoring paper. See these topics, politics and society, you can use in essay also, essay and ethics. You get a lot of points from here. Again, one every topic, year one, you get one essay on sexual division of labor, women related. You can use direct points from here, scholars also. So, study the syllabus again and again, read it by heart the words. We'll start this syllabus optional soon. Okay, I will put one or some more videos and start the syllabus soon. Complete help will be from the other from my side. Yesterday I taught you the introduction, told you, discussed with you the introduction. There was a picture about with the potter's wheel, right? How I will mold you. That is also very important. And now you have to, tomorrow I'll come with paper, the analysis of paper two. Join the optional and I guarantee very good marks. You know that sociology is a very easy subject, right? So once you start the optional, we'll learn by writing and you will get a lot of marks in the optional. It will help in essay also, ethics paper also. So four papers are guaranteed, two papers of optional, one paper of essay and one ethics paper. These four papers are actually very important in getting very good ranks, very good service and your preferred cadre. So this actually comes from your optional and this is, see the words, it is very easy to understand, right? Now we will go for paper two later and we'll study in a way that we get lot of marks. Okay, thank you for your time. Join the optional batch. We'll go as a family. So thank you for your time. All the best. Study well. God bless.